Hi children, welcome back to our channel Rise and Shine. Hope all of you are fine. So in yesterday's episode we saw that Shivaji captured many forts. So in order to stop Shivaji and Shaji Bhosle was arrested and kept in prison. So, Shivaji had to be silent for 7 years. But he was not silent. He was silently establishing his army. From 1640 to 1657, Shivaji had captured 40 forts. So, in order to stop Shivaji from developing into a powerful king, the Bijapur Bade Begum sent Afzal Khan with 10,000 soldiers to destroy Shivaji. Afzal Khan was a very cruel and a brutal man, but he was gigantic and very strong. He was very, very powerful and strong. To make Shivaji fight in open, he desecrated Hindu places of worship, and also he killed many civilians, that is ordinary people. So Shivaji wanted to talk to him, but he did not accept to talk to Shivaji. But they had a war, and Shivaji used guerrilla tactics from Pratapgarh fort, and he wanted to do chapamar, that means hide and fight. That was Shivaji's technique. He used to hide in the mountains and fight. So finally, one day, Afzal Khan accepted to meet Shivaji. A meeting was arranged, and Shivaji went to meet Afzal Khan. But actually, Afzal Khan planned to kill Shivaji. But Shivaji went there well prepared. He wore an iron armor. He had tiger claws and a dagger. That means a small sword he had. And he went to meet Afzal Khan. When he went to meet Afzal Khan, Afzal Khan, as if he wanted to hug Shivaji, he put out his hands to embrace Shivaji, but he wanted to squeeze him, suffocating him, and in that way he wanted to kill Shivaji. So when Afzal Khan embraced Shivaji, and as Shivaji was wearing the armor, Shivaji was saved. Shivaji now took out the tiger claws which he had brought, and he tore open Afzal Khan's stomach and killed him with the tiger claws. And After that, he was able to defeat the army of Afzal Khan. And then again, Rustum Jaman was sent in 1659, and he was defeated by Shivaji cleverly. Then in 1660, again there was a war, and now, as Shivaji was very pious, he was very religious. So many Hindu temples were damaged by Afzal Khan and party. Shivaji was very sad about this, and Bhaji Prabhu was a Maharashtra warrior who helped Shivaji to defeat the sultans. So Shivaji fought with them bravely, and he defeated them in the war. And Shaista Khan was sent again with 150,000 soldiers. But Shivaji was defeated, and Shivaji again cleverly went into the fort with 400 soldiers dressed up as a marriage party. And Shivaji entered the fort. The Lal Fort of Shivaji was occupied by Shaista Khan, and Shivaji went into the fort and he attacked Shaista Khan, whose three fingers were cut off, but he escaped from there. And Shivaji, from a very early age, he started his fights. Now, Shivaji defeated the army. You can see Shivaji's army had men on elephants, men on horses, and men on foot. So this time, Raja Jai Singh was sent. Shivaji was defeated and taken to Agra, from where he escaped. So we can see about Shivaji's escape from Agra. In this chapter, we could see how Shivaji defeated Afzal Khan, a very ferocious and a very strong person. He was double the weight of Shivaji. Shivaji would have died if he was not clever enough, if he had not worn the armor inside his dress. So inside his robes he wore that armor, so that when Afzal Khan wanted to squeeze up Shivaji, he was not successful. Instead, Shivaji